Yvonne Okwara. The hashtag once again is Lords of Hate. We look forward to hearing from you on this issue that has plagued the country for quite some time now. The Kenyan National Assembly Speaker Justin Muturi has rejected an impeachment motion against Devolution Cabinet Secretary Anne Waiguru. This was after some lawmakers withdrew their signatures, making the motion fall short of the required minimum threshold. Reacting to this new development, the sponsor of the motion, Nandi Hills Member of Parliament Alfred Kitter, cried foul and claimed some MPs had been threatened and forced to withdraw their signatures, while others had allegedly been promised a 1 million shillings bribe each to withdraw their support.
2 weeks ago, Nandi Hills lawmaker Alfred Keter had submitted to the clerk of the National Assembly his motion seeking to impeach Devolution Cabinet Secretary Anne Waiguru. He had support of 97 MPs who had appended their signatures to the motion. According to the House rules, the motion required a minimum of 87 signatures to be approved by the Speaker and 117 MPs to sail through during voting. But Keter got a rude awakening when National Assembly Speaker Justin Muturi informed him the motion could not proceed after 17 MPs withdrew their signatures for the motion. Keter has cried foul and claimed some MPs were bribed to withdraw signatures.
They have promised that if you withdraw your signature, you get 1 million shillings.
Keter insists he'll continue with the crusade to remove Waiguru from office. Keter wants Waiguru impeached for gross violation of the constitution in the management of the National Youth Service, leading to loss of public funds and financial irregularities. NYS that falls under Waiguru's docket is being investigated for the loss of 791 million shillings through manipulation of the Integrated Financial Management Information System. Keter expressed optimism that he will resubmit the motion to the Speaker next week, since the motion fell short of the threshold by 8 MPs.
I'm on course. No one is going to intimidate me, no one is going to threaten me, no one is going to bribe me. I will stick to this course because we have to fight corruption.
Keter has come under pressure to withdraw the impeachment motion. Early this month, a section of Kalenjin elders from the Rift Valley urged him to drop the motion, claiming Keter was being used by the opposition to rock the Jubilee administration. Leader of Majority in the National Assembly Aden Duale and Kericho Senator Charles Keter have also urged Keter to drop the motion or face defeat on the floor of the House.
Jubilee cannot take a position as a party towards supporting someone who is corrupt. Everyone must step aside. The President was very clear early this year. He stated very clearly that anybody whose docket has issues to do with corruption must step aside. And once cleared, they resume office.
This is the second attempt to remove Waiguru. In May 2014, Igembe South lawmaker Mithika Linturi failed to appear in Parliament to move his motion that sought to impeach Waiguru even after garnering 98 signatures. Linturi had accused Waiguru of intimidating and threatening public servants. Patrick Amimo, KTN News.